Hi, I'm Pia. I'm an economic researcher and I teach macroeconomics. In this video, we're going to learn about the real economy in the long run and one of its main issues, unemployment. In order to do so, we're going to start by defining what is the long run in macroeconomics. Then, we're going to review the concept of economic growth as well as its main drivers. Then, we'll define and explore the concept of unemployment. And finally, we will apply it to the long run. That's when we are going to learn about the natural rate of unemployment. With this content, you'll be able to understand a very common phenomenon associated to the real economic cycle and its interpretations. So let's begin. What do we mean when we speak of long-run production? The first thing that we have to keep in mind is price flexibility. Price flexibility is not the same for all goods and services. That is why, in macroeconomics, we use an assumption in order to simplify and establish the difference between the short run and the long run. This assumption consists on the fact that the prices of final products sold to consumers are more flexible than input prices. In other words, the cost of each factor of production used to produce a final good or service is more inflexible in the short term than the price of the final good itself. What's the most common example? Wages. Wages are the payments for labor, which is an input used for most final products. Wages have two main qualities. First of all, they are adjusted periodically and not automatically. And also, they have downward inflexibility, which means as they adjust, they are unlikely to be reduced. Those qualities are significantly different from final products, which can adjust their prices more quickly. So, the short run consists on the time horizon over which the wages and prices of other inputs to production are inflexible. Within this time frame, it is assumed that there may be imbalances, since some prices may have adjusted to changes in market conditions, those of the final products, while others have not, those of the inputs. And the long run consists on the period of time over which these input prices have the time to adjust. In this case, the overall price level, contractual wage rates, and expectations are fully adjusted in equilibrium, which allows us to make analysis regarding GDP and general prices. Now that we understand the concept of long run, let's see how that applies to economic growth. Economic growth is defined by an increase in the market value of the goods and services that an economy produces over time. It is measured as the percentage rate in the real gross domestic product. Why real domestic product? Because this indicator seeks to capture whether there is genuine growth in the total output by isolating the impact of inflation. One country can experience economic growth from one year to another. That is, if the real GDP has increased over a certain period of time. However, if we want to talk about the long run, this growth has to occur long enough for all prices to adjust. So long-run economic growth consists on a sustained rise in the quantity of goods and services that an economy produces. Many economists theorize about what makes an economy grow in a sustained manner. Among the main debates, we can extract three main factors. First of all, growth of productivity. It is associated to the availability of physical capital or the fact that the cost of products decreases as production rises. In other words, the optimization or minimization of the costs related to the inputs. Secondly, demographic changes. The population structure can be crucial. For example, a higher educated population can lead to higher industrialization and higher GDP. It is also important to keep in mind the ratio between demographic growth and the availability of natural resources. Finally, the labor force participation or the size of its workforce. Sustainable growth requires an equilibrium between these factors. Each factor is not always enough. Assuming that a country achieves economic growth in the long run, can that have negative consequences? Yes, it can. Unemployment can be a serious consequence of long-run economic growth. Let's see why. First of all, what is unemployment? and how do we measure it? Unemployment refers to a situation where a person actively searches for employment but is unable to find work. It is measured with the unemployment rate, which is the percentage of people in the workforce who are looking for a job but are unemployed. There are different types or causes of unemployment: frictional, seasonal, structural, and cyclical. Frictional unemployment occurs when people are switching from one job to another. This type of unemployment is supposed to be only temporary. Seasonal unemployment is associated, as its name says, to the changes in season, which lead to an amount of people running out of jobs, such as ski instructors or ice cream vendors. Structural unemployment is a little bit more difficult to deal with, since it has to do with changes in technology or a country's production structure. For example, if a country decides to increase tax burden on a certain industry, the firms will try to reduce costs, leading for some employees to be left out and have to look for a job on another sector with higher labor demand. Finally, cyclical unemployment is associated with downturns in economic cycles such as recessions. It is in these moments when aggregate demand is depressed, production decreases, and consequently so does employment. At first, when speaking of long-run real economics, we may think that cyclical unemployment is the only possible consequence. However, other types of unemployment may occur, even when the economy is growing. So, long-run economic growth can be associated with negative issues, such as unemployment. Productivity shifts, such as changes in the production structure, although associated to economic growth, can lead to structural or frictional unemployment. The same happens when technology is moving forward. Some people may get left out of this progress. Binding all these causes together, we may arrive at one conclusion. The unemployment rate is never zero. There are always people changing between jobs or being laid off because of a structural or seasonal change. Economists have debated over this, arriving at the concept of the natural rate of unemployment, or the non-accelerating inflation rate of unemployment. If an economy is experiencing this rate of unemployment, then it would actually be in full employment, since this consists on workers structurally and frictionally unemployed. According to the OECD, the United States has full employment when the unemployment rate is between 5 and 6%. However, this number fluctuates depending on the nation, the time period, and the economic opinions of the politicians. The importance of the natural rate of unemployment is that it states a level of full employment for an economy and consequently a healthy real GDP level. This was developed by Keynesian economics. This theory positioned the government as a key player in offsetting the economic cycle, boosting demand, and reactivating growth. In this case, according to Keynesian economics, the government should monitor the level of unemployment in order for it to be above the natural rate of unemployment. Why is some unemployment healthy? Because some governments base their decisions on this rate when deciding how much to stimulate the economy and how seriously to take inflation into account. At first, the classical theory says that unemployment rate can be below the natural rate without causing inflation. However, according to Keynesian economics, inflation is likely to occur if the unemployment rate falls below the natural rate of unemployment. Keynesians advise the government to stimulate the economy if unemployment rises to levels that are significantly higher, since this causes the economy to stagnate. With everything we just covered, it's time for a quick exercise. We've talked a lot about unemployment. What kinds of unemployment always exist when we are talking about long-term growth? If you answer structural or frictional unemployment, you're correct. Remember, the unemployment rate is never zero. There are always people changing jobs or being laid off because of a structural or a seasonal change. Which are the most common mistakes? First of all, remember that unemployment measures people unemployed who are looking for a job. This means people who are not employed and aren't looking for a job are not being considered in this indicator. Also, even though the natural rate of unemployment refers to a level of full employment and ideal real GDP, this does not mean that there aren't people without jobs. There is always frictional and structural unemployment. Wrapping up, we've seen in this video that long-run economic growth can lead to unemployment. This may be caused by structural changes in production or even progress in technology or productivity. That is why some economists and governments consider the natural rate of unemployment. This is natural because it's mostly frictional or structural, and it establishes full employment and real GDP levels. So, economic growth can have many issues. One of them, as we have seen, is unemployment. Have you seen cases where this happens? Hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you'd like to learn more, please feel free to explore on Chegg.